And welcome to C++ Weekly. I am your host, Jason Turner, and I am available for code reviews and on-site training. In this episode, we're going to explore a new C++ 26 feature involving structured bindings and expansion packs. It'll be curious to see how much this feature actually ends up being used in light of the fact that C++ 26 is also getting some reflection capabilities. But Clang supports this today, and it seems to be full support theoretically, so we will see what happens. Okay, I just created this inspect function. Now, we're going to do something that is absolutely impossible before C++ 26. The idea is that I am going to automatically expand this values to represent the set of things that are in the object. Now, of course, I did put these dots on the wrong side because I'm introducing a parameter pack. I am not expanding the parameter pack. Here's an interesting aside if you didn't know it, that yes, it is perfectly valid to declare a type inside of a function in C++. Now I'm simply going to pass value to inspect, and we're going to see what exactly we can do with this in here. Const star value reference makes no sense. We want a const L value reference. Unused variable values. Okay, that is an expected error. So let's do things. I have created a structured binding of an unknown number of parameters from this thing that was passed to me. This is an implicitly a template function in C++ 20. I have an auto parameter here. This is making a template. Now I am introducing a parameter pack. This is the C++ 26 feature that we care about. I am then doing a variadic size of, which is a C++ 11 feature to say how many elements were in this parameter pack that just got created for me by the compiler. So I can see that this thing has three elements. This next line is going to look pretty suspect to many of you if you're not used to writing code like this. I am doing a C++ 17 fold expression over this pack of elements. So I am saying print the elem, and the first parameter here is the count. The second parameter here is the value. This dot 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 is going to do an expansion over the comma operator. These things are going to be executed in order that is required with the comma operator, so I know it will be strictly evaluated left to right. Now I forgot my new line, but we can see here that I am able to inspect this thing, see that it has three elements in it, and I can access each of these elements with my fold expression. And we can see I got 1, 2, and 4.3 exactly as expected. And it really shouldn't care how many elements this has. It should be able to print all of the things in here no matter what. With this code, I have no way of knowing what the name of that particular field was in the struct that I am doing this structured binding over. I just know its value, and then I can also get its type if I were so inclined by using something like decal type and using type traits on it. There you have it. This is an interesting new feature from C++ 26. And with a little bit of imagination, we could see how this might be used for perhaps doing some sort of JSON serialization, for example. And now I reach the limitations of using a local struct in that I cannot have static const expert data in the local struct. So as you can see, this clearly needs some work, and it'll probably be almost immediately outmodded by reflection support coming in C++ 26 as well. But also, I hope you see a little bit of potential here, where with some very minimal effort, we can kind of serialize whatever things we want to, or something, do some sort of base level introspection of these things, print the elements, count them, perhaps make a quick JSON serializer with just a few lines of code, and it wouldn't take much more effort to make this thing so it recursively calls itself in the case that it's not a primitive type and it needs to further serialize the thing that happens to be contained in it. Parsing it back out's its own other problem. Anyhow, thank you for watching this episode of C++ Weekly. I hope you enjoyed it and learned something new. Be sure to subscribe, and I will catch you at an upcoming training.